ما الحكمة من تعرض بعض الأطفال للاعتداءات والأمراض مع أنهم لا ذنوب لهم؟ What is the wisdom behind children being exposed to transgressions, to sicknesses, although they have no sins?
أولا لابد أن نعلم أن الله جل وعلا لا يفعل الشر.
First of all, we should know that Allah عز وجل does not do evil.
وكل فعله لحكمة.
All of his actions are for a wisdom.
فقد تراه أنت شرا وهو ليس بشر عند الله تبارك وتعالى.
You might view it to be evil, but it is not evil with Allah عز وجل.
وصحيح أن الأطفال لا يعاقبون.
It is true that the children are not punished in this worldly life.
ولكن لأن الله تبارك وتعالى أحيانا.
But it is because that sometimes Allah سبحانه وتعالى
يريد أن يعجل لهم بالجنة.
He wants to rush them to enter paradise.
وذلك أنه من المعلوم.
That is because it is well known.
بإجماع أهل العلم.
With the unanimous agreement of the people of knowledge.
كما نقل ذلك ابن عبد البر.
As Ibn Abd al-Barr has reported that.
وإن خالف البعض في ذلك.
Even though some disagreed with him in this.
أن أطفال المسلمين الذين يموتون قبل البلوغ من أهل الجنة.
That the children, the Muslim children who die before reaching the age of puberty, then they are from the people of paradise.
والذي عليه جماهير أهل العلم.
What the position that the vast majority, the overwhelming majority of the people of knowledge are upon?
أن أطفال المشركين الذين لم يبلغ الحلم أيضا وماتوا.
That the children of the polytheists, the mushrikeen, who did not reach the age of puberty and they died before that.
كذلك من أهل الجنة.
They are likewise from the people of paradise.
لأن الأصل أن كل مولود يولد على الفطرة.
Because the principle is that. Every newborn is born according to the state of the natural disposition of Islam.
كما في الصحيحين.
As in the two Sahihs, Bukhari and Muslim.
وكذلك جاء في بعض الأحاديث.
Likewise, there has come in some أحاديث.
أن كل مولود يولد على الإسلام.
That every newborn is born upon Islam.
فلذلك.
This is why.
لا تظنن أن هذا تعذيب من الله تبارك وتعالى لهم.
Do not ever think that this is a torture that Allah عز وجل is torturing those children.
وإنما قد يكون هذا تنبيها لغيرهم.
Rather, this might actually be to bring the attention and to alert those who are other than them.
حتى يعرف نعمة الصحة التي رزقها أولاده.
So that he will recognize the favor of health that Allah عز وجل has granted his children.
فيعتني بهؤلاء الأولاد.
So he would look after those kids.
وهم أيضا لا يضرهم ذلك بل هم مكرمون عند الله تبارك وتعالى.
And they are not harmed by that, those kids. They are not harmed by that. لا يضرهم ذلك عند الله هؤلاء
الذين. بالعكس ينعمون.
Rather they are going to be, this does not harm them, rather they are going to be enjoying in paradise.
ولذلك صار الأنبياء أكثر الناس بلاء.
This is why the prophets, they are the ones who are tried the most.
مع أنهم أكرم خلق الله عليه.
Although they are the most honored of the creation in the sight of Allah.
وقال ابن مسعود للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو في مرض الموت.
ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه said to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم while he was in his sickness of death.
إنك توعك وعكا شديدا.
He said you are going through so much pain.
فقال له النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him.
إني أوعك رجلين منكم.
I receive, I go through pain like two men amongst you.
فقال له ابن مسعود.
So ابن مسعود said to him.
أذلك لأن لك الأجر مرتين.
Is this because you received the reward twice?
قال نعم.
He said yes.
فهؤلاء أكرم الخلق على الله.
These are the most honored creation by Allah.
ويبتلوا.
Yet they are being tried.
بل جاء في الحديث.
Rather, there has come in the hadith.
أن الناس يوم القيامة.
That the people on the day of judgment.
يتمنون أن لو عاشوا في البلاء في هذه الدنيا.
They wish that they will live through a lot of trials in this worldly life.
لما يرون من إكرام الله تبارك وتعالى الذين ابتلوا في هذه الدنيا.
Because of what they see of the honor and the generosity that Allah engulfs those people who were in pain and trials in this worldly life.
ولعل هناك حكما أخرى لا نعلمها والعلم عند الله جل وعلا.
And maybe there are other wisdoms that we do not know, and Allah is the most knowledgeable, subhanahu wa ta'ala.